Hi everyone, this is Master Hope coming to you from my Fitness Protection Connection program. I am your master of disaster. Today we are going to learn a new technique involving the hands, of course, right now. And we'll show you the target areas and things like that in just a minute. It's going to be called the clasp grasp, okay? So you want to put your hands together, put those thumbs going forward, not overlapped, but going forward so that way you're pressing them together and have a nice stability for that, for the strike, okay? But first, let's go ahead and get warmed up for some of the moves that we're going to incorporate with it in the direction. All right, so just go ahead and rotate the shoulders, of course, if you want to do that, keeping your neck in alignment with that, going forward. Got a little background music going today for you as well. Okay, now our twisting motion again. Keep those cores nice and centered here. Pulling in the belly button to the back. Breathing normally in and out. Good. You want to just kind of keep those hands up there. There you go. Okay, and then you're going to bring the elbows out. There you go. You don't have to move, or you can. It's up to you. All right, then we're gonna rotate those hips, getting those adductors stretched out. And the other way. Good. Then we go ahead and rotate those knees. Today we're doing the knees because we're gonna be doing some lunging going forward, okay? So proper alignment for that real quick is to make sure that your knee is in alignment with your ankle. Don't let it press past the toes there, okay? So here we go. So for the lunging motion, you're just gonna step forward, dip that back leg, step, there you go. Keeping the shoulders over the hips here. There you go. All right, now you're gonna push the hands forward. The little push motion there, like get back, stay back, pushing. All right, now you're gonna swing them up, going up, and then pulling them back. Up, breathe in, pull back, and breathe out. In, out, good. Rotate the wrists, of course. All right, good. Okay, so again, here we go with the clasp, like praying hands, but interlock the fingers together. Thumbs go on top. You can do this with the eye gouge as well. However, what we're gonna target on today is the face area, mostly, but there's some other areas too. So on my bag here, for your clasp move, some of the targets, again, with the temple, the top of the nose. Today we're going to do underneath the chin as well, okay, and also to the groin area. So here we go. So get those hands clasped together. All right, for the top of the nose, what you're going to do is you're going to step forward like we did in our warm-up, okay, and hammering down straight on top of the bridge of the nose. You can also do to the top of the temple of the head as well, striking and breathing out. This is a great move if your hands happen to be tied together, ziplocked, handcuffed. Don't do it if you got arrested though, okay? So anyway, remember, it's only for your self-defense. All right, if you happen to have gotten kidnapped or taken or whatever, you know, so there are moves that you can do if your hands are together. All right, so here you go again. All right, now this time you're gonna do like a swinger's bat going side to side here, okay, pulling them in, reaching out, striking to the side of the temple, in, out, swing, in, out, swing. Again, really getting a big torso movement there, okay, with the twist. All right, now you also have a going upward motion, so we're gonna step forward. Again, the thumbs are gonna go right up to the bottom of the chin level there, okay? Swinging it up like if you've ever played volleyball, scooping it, the arms down and bringing it up, striking right underneath the chin there. And eventually what's going to happen is their neck is going to come back, their chin back, neck back, and it's going to snap a little bit and you know, get the desired disorientation that you want so that you can run. All right, so you got those moves there, top of the temple or the nose, or top of the head, or to the bridge of the nose, side to side, temples, There you go. All right, and then scooping up to the bottom of the chin. Now from a rear attack to, again, swinging motion, straightening, boom, twisting, boom, twisting, boom, there. Okay, so you got that. And also scooping forward, I forgot this one, to the groin area. Again, stepping forward, just going right below the belt there, lunging forward and swinging as hard as you can right into the groin area. Again, having the motion coming straight up. Okay, you don't want to just stop it there. You want to swing as high as you can, as hard as you can, breathing out, stepping forward, and swinging. If you don't get a chance to get off with a step forward, then just scoop down and squat down and then scoop up. So speaking of that, let's go ahead and do some squats. All right, so just to get your body into that muscle memory as you're doing these motions so that your body will follow what you're thinking. Good. Okay, then of course stretch it out, bringing the calf back. If you can't, okay, stretch it out that way, just go ahead and grab onto your foot there. All right, if you can't, or if you're wearing leggings, go ahead and grab onto them. If you can't do the whole ankle thing, that's fine. All right, okay, so that is your clasp motion today. All right, y'all be safe out there. This is Master Hope, once again, coming to you from Florida in my sweatshed. Have a great day and be safe.